Well, delayed and cancelled flights, lost baggage, crying babies. Travelling by plane isn't always as easy as we'd like it to be, but how far could you get without flying? Well, Danish traveller Thor Pedersen has managed to visit 196 countries in 9 years and counting.
Country number 196 just happens to be Australia, and the man himself joined us a little earlier from Melbourne. Thor, thank you very much for joining us. Welcome to our country. I have to say, though, number 196, should we be offended, or are you saving the best for last?
I'm saving the best for last, obviously.
So is Australia your final stop then, or do you have more to see?
Yeah, I'm trying real hard to reach New Zealand right now. I have 7 countries left, so there is New Zealand, Samoa, Tonga, Vanuatu, Tuvalu, Sri Lanka and Maldives, and then I'll be on my way home.
So all of those countries are better than Australia? Is that what you're saying?
No. I came to Australia to recharge my battery, so I had the strength to go to the remaining countries.
What a diplomat. This is fantastic. You have seen more of the world than just about anybody. You are in the perfect position to answer this. What's the best country and what's the worst country?
Best country is obviously Australia. Which other country could I answer? So, based on a philosophy that whichever country I'm in has to be the best country in the world because it is to someone within the country, and I'm trying to promote the country while I am there. So I'm trying to look for good things and promote the most positive. So Australia is the best country in the world. The worst would be the Vatican. I think that's a rubbish country. It's got nothing to do with religion. It's just that it's a country that closes at night. No children are born there. There are no restaurants. There are no hotels. What kind of country is that?
Thor, I thought the days of trailblazing explorers were over. What inspired you to pursue this goal of seeing every country without flying?
Yeah, a bit of craziness, I guess. Maybe it's my Viking heritage to go out and explore and conquer. But originally, it just came about when I discovered that very few people have been to every country in the world, and no one has managed to do it completely without flying. So I thought that was my shot at doing something with my life, which I consider historical, and hopefully inspire and motivate some people along the way.
And we hear you arrived on our shores by cargo ship. How did you manage? Yeah. How did you manage that? Were you a stowaway?
Yes, I was a stowaway. I booked myself inside a container. They locked the container, and then I was just lucky I ended up in Australia. That's how that works.
You call yourself a modern Viking. Does that mean you can kind of do things in a different way and sort of have a different strategy towards how you run around the world?
Yes, I do try to murder someone in every country I go to, so that's been a part of it. No, I mean, I come from Denmark. Denmark is Viking territory. It was Viking territory 1,000 years ago. We have proud traditions with that. So this is now 2022. I can't very much call myself a Viking anymore, so I'd be a modern Viking.
You actually started this journey way back in 2013. I'm figuring, given the pandemic was so recent, did that in any way slow things down for you?
Oh, did it ever. I was on a ship from the Federated States of Micronesia heading towards Hong Kong, where I was supposed to be for 4 days. That was 4 days of transit. And then I would continue to Palau and then continue and then be home years ago. But what happened when I reached Hong Kong was the pandemic struck and I got caught inside Hong Kong. There was nowhere I could go. I could go to the airport, but that would end the project. So, 2 years in Hong Kong. And then this year I was able to go to Palau and then come here to Australia.
So outside of the pandemic, have you found yourself in any really like dicey, dangerous situations?
There have been some. I think danger is something that you can measure in different ways. Sometimes you're in danger and you don't even know. I know for a fact that 3 of the ships that I've traveled on board are at the bottom of the sea today. I hope it doesn't have anything to do with me, but that's a known fact, confirmed ships at the bottom of the sea. And that could easily have happened while I was on board. But also, sometimes you run into people that have foul intentions. Once or twice I've had people point a weapon towards my face and be very aggressive. And in one particular case in Central Africa, I thought it was the end of everything. I didn't think I had a living chance that I would ever get out of it, but I did, and now I'm in Australia.
Thor, all the best for your future travels. Good luck getting home, and thanks very much for speaking with us.
Well, thank you. It's been a pleasure.
Can I just say, that project, which is called Once Upon a Saga, I think.
Yeah.
What a project.
What a project. I don't know what you do at the end. Like, how do you live the rest of your life when you've seen that many countries?
Right, you know what? You go to the moon without a plane. That's what you do.
We need to get him in touch with Elon Musk, or one of those billionaires that are travelling there.